Hello, I'm Phil Svitek, 360 Creative Coach, and welcome to my vlog, where it's both my mission and my pleasure to highlight my creative journey and share the insights that I've gained, all in hopes that it makes your journey just a little bit easier. Now, before I fully dive into things, I would like to take the opportunity to invite you to subscribe if you haven't already. That way you get all the various lessons and episodes that I put out right when I put them out. Thank you if you just did, and thank you if you already were. It truly does mean a lot to me, as I hope it does to you. So let's get into it. A lot of last week was just kind of tidying up loose ends as far as my maker involvement with my feature film, meaning there was some voice recordings that we had done with the actors called ADR that I needed to send to my sound designer, right? You know, it's stuff that fix, you know, certain lines that just need to be re-recorded for one reason or another. And so, you know, I did that and other things, right? Just basically getting it, so everything in terms of what I call the maker, or it's rather a term that a lot of people use, but getting that stuff off my plate so I can be a full manager. And so the majority of all that was last week. And the nice part was, in terms of being a maker, you know, for so long it was the, I don't want to do it in terms of importance or whatever, but it was a lot of the stuff that, you know, was longer term, right? Whereas some of the other stuff that I'm going to talk about now, they were quick fire items that I knew I could get done in a short amount of time, but they, in terms of the order of necessary completion to continue things, you know, they weren't a priority. But finally, you know, as we're in this stage of things, I was able to do them. So, for example, finally, I was able to get the poster, the first official poster for this film, A Bogota Trip, completed, which I, you know, you can see it on IMDb. If you just type in A Bogota Trip or, you know, our website, philsvitek.com/a-bogota-trip. Links are all down below, but anyway, and it's also, I'm posting it on social media. But the point is, you know, I was able to get that completed, right? And knock that off my list, which I always knew wouldn't be a long thing, but again, it just wasn't the right time to focus on that. So I got that done. I got the website done. And, you know, I even created what I'm calling like a yearbook, right? So these are all the various things that I was able to knock off my plate. And now I'm really just managing people and helping them, basically clearing the path for their success. And I'm going to talk about, you know, completing the week in a moment, but I want to talk about this side of it, right? Because that was my big goal, was to get to where I'm just completely a manager. And, you know, one of the things I decided was to, you know, connect with everyone, you know, my sound designer, the VFX artist, composer, all that, colorist, yada, yada, yada. Anyone essentially, you know, working on the movie at this stage of it, and let them know, like, hey, here's our deadline. And based on that, why don't you create benchmarks that work, so that way I'm not hassling you and being like, hey, any updates? Like, you can create the times that's going to be your due date, you know, milestones, whatever you want to call them. And that way we both have an expectation. And, you know, it's so we have a goal in mind. And the deadline is not to create more pressure, but if for some reason, you know, we need to adjust, we can do that. And furthermore, if we start kind of, you know, missing them, then we could discuss together and be like, okay, what support do you need from me to make it happen, right? So that's the goal. And, you know, so I got those deadlines back and, you know, we're moving forward with that. And it's good, you know, I think it's just good for everybody to essentially be on the same page and have something that we're all aiming for, right? So I like them deciding it because gives them that sort of freedom. After all, they know better in terms of their schedules, the requirements needed, and so forth. I mean, for me, as long as we make that deadline, that hard deadline that I've set for us, that's really all that matters to me, right? You know, how we get there is in some ways irrelevant in terms of that, right? So that was the logic behind that. And yeah, it worked out well. Or, you know, obviously all we did was essentially create those deadlines, but we're moving forward. And it's not like this is like the first time that they're doing anything. All these things have been going slowly in the works, in the background, but now it's just a more formalized game plan, right? So again, being in that manager mode, that's what I can do. I can be that support system. Going back, I had used 99 Designs for the poster, and I like using 99 Designs because it allows you to get a variety of designs from multiple artists, and so you get to see their interpretation, and essentially you pick the one you like the most, and so it allows for revisions and stuff like that. And I really like what we had created on this one. I think it looks really good. I think it pops, it's colorful, it shows the vibrancy and the liveliness of what the movie represents, right? So I think it's awesome. The other aspect was the website. For me, just personally, it's a lot to manage. Like, in the ideal scenario, this would have its own separate website, and separate social media accounts and so forth. But as far as social media, I'd much rather the individual people get the followings, right? The actors, the crew, and myself, because I think, it's just a lot of work to manage an entire separate social media account, and at the same time, just even like for popular movies, right? Unless it's like something like Marvel or whatever, there's not that much engagement. So I don't see the upside of doing that. So I essentially made, website, web page more so through my website. So it's just kind of the information there. People, if they want to be updated, they can sign up there. Just kind of providing the general information. But of course, IMDb is there as well, and I updated that, which actually went a lot smoother this time. With my first movie, it was originally titled Idol, and when it gained distribution, they decided to retitle it to Love Market, which I agree with. But for the longest time, the poster and the name of the movie on IMDb were the original versions, and I just couldn't find a way to get that changed. And still, I finally was able to get the poster changed, but not the actual title. I mean, if you look up Love Market, Idol does come up, but it's weird in that way, because obviously I want Love Market, because that's the name of the movie that's out there and available to purchase, right? So it's always been kind of frustrating just in terms of fixing or changing things on IMDb. But with A Bogota Trip, it actually, there was no poster that we posted, so that was easy enough. I just uploaded the one that's now official. And for whatever reason, this time around, changing the title was super simple. So that's all taken care of, which sounds like a minor thing, but I don't know, it's certainly frustrating when that seemingly minor thing isn't working the way that it's intended, right? So I appreciate that's taken care of, and I can move on to other stuff, right? Also, another, fun thing for me was finally getting to sit with and complete what I'm calling the yearbook. And the yearbook is just you know, much like a school yearbook, a collection of photos from the trip, right? A scrapbook, if you will. And so I used Shutterfly to create this. I looked at other, you know, it's not, there's so many services, and I didn't pick Shutterfly. Just, it seems like a well-known thing. And one of the reasons that I did choose it was what I understood as that I could create like a digital copy of it, meaning, you know, I could just export out a PDF version of this as well, which is what I wanted to do to send to people, you know, that contributed towards the movie financially through the Indiegogo campaign and so forth, because to print an actual physical copy, you know, is costly. So anyway, I went through Shutterfly, and the nice part is they have, you know, I went through and picked out the photos that I wanted, and then I labeled each photo numerically in terms of, like, you know, each section would be, like, for example, I included pictures of our rehearsals, right? So that would be like 01 and then dash rehearsal 1, 01 dash rehearsal 2, and so forth, right? And then, you know, the, let's say the third day of filming, you know, that's 05 dash, you know, day 1, even though it's the third day, you know, 05 dash day 2, right? Because the last number refers to the pictures. Anyway, the point is I labeled everything in this way, so that way it would be sequential. And I uploaded it into Shutterfly. And the nice part is there's various options of, essentially for free, you can have a designer, you know, put it all in. So I was like, okay, well, if it's free, why not? You know, that's a weight off mine, right? Like, they'll make it all aesthetically pleasing and so forth. And there's various options with that you can have. You know, you can tell them, like, use all the images, use most of the images, or use some of the images, whatever it may be, right? And so that came back, and it was good. And so I ordered these for the cast. Because I want, you know, that's like my my wrap gift for them, right? This special keepsake. And, you know, it's not cheap. You know, even just $5, though, this for the five main actors, you know, it's not cheap. But I it was a special time, you know, together. We made this movie and so forth, and it was a big commitment. So I want us to look fondly back on that, and I think this is going to be one of those great memories, right? But I also, like I said, I wanted this to be available to people as well, through just a digital copy. But apparently that's not possible. Not unless you want a watermark that just says preview, which sucks. So if there is a service out there that doesn't require that you can actually just spit out a PDF version, let me know. I'm very curious, you know. I know part of this might sound like I've been doing a Shutterfly commercial, but I'm actually not. I'm just telling you my experience. In terms of, like, the physical copy, I'm sure will look great, you know. I think we came up with a pretty good design, and like I said, the photos that I selected are really awesome. Looking forward to getting that and being able to gift it to the hosts, or not the hosts, the cast. Which they don't know. I mean, I've kind of talked about it, so maybe they know. But I just texted all of them, like, hey, your wrap gift, long overdue, is coming. You know, I can either drop it off or we can get together and I can give it to you then. So hopefully we'll have a nice mini reunion, maybe this weekend, maybe the next weekend. And I can give it to them, and it'll be cool. And even though it's probably, you know, like I said, it won't be like a total surprise, but I think they'll still be pleasantly smiling, at least, right, when they receive it, right? So that's the exciting part. And that's really, like, as far as the movie, we're coming up, you know. Now it's more about the marketing plan of it all, you know, like we're starting the festival circuit, and not that we're in any festival yet, but certainly, you know, we've applied to festivals, I've contacted each festival with a cover letter and spoken with them and so forth to make sure it's on their radar, and gotten, you know, so far good responses from everyone there. A few of them I haven't heard back yet in terms of my initial email, but that's okay. You know, I'll give them some space and, you know, follow up when the time is right. And yeah, it's just kind of like, it's interesting. We're sort of in the thick of it, if you will, right? Like, this is the stage that, you know, you want to be in. And yet, you know, that's going to be a long journey in of itself, because just like in general, you submit to a festival and then months go by before you hear a response. And then it might be another month before the actual festival itself. So, you know, it's a journey, and you just have to have that patience with it. And I was talking with another filmmaker friend of mine, and it, you know, right now the version submitted is still a work in progress, which in an ideal world you would want to have obviously the final version. But it's tough because, A, there's the final deadlines. Like I said, I mean, even some of these have like a final deadline for submission. And even though like we're still like in April, some of them won't happen till like early October, right? So if you miss that deadline, you know, you might not be able to play a festival till 2023, which is a long time. Likewise, you know, sometimes for the festivals, like they have early submissions, they have regular submission, and they have final submission. And thinking about, you know, and thinking about and talking about it with people, like, it is advantageous to apply early, because most people are applying primarily for the regular and late submissions, because, you know, they're trying to submit in the best quality of work. But that means a lot of people are, and so not every movie gets to be seen, right? So it's not that things are selected that far in advance necessarily, although that could happen as well. It's more so, you know, if you submit early, you have a higher chance of them actually watching it, which seems messed up, but it's just, listen, it's just the fact of the beast, you know? So it's a complicated matter, and you just try to give yourself the best chances you can. But as I, you know, worked on that, you know, it's now, in terms of having to do anything, it's maybe like 20 minutes a week in terms of checking in on festival stuff, seeing if there's new ones, you know, calling people, whatever it may be. Like, my involvement at that point is very minimal, or at this point, rather. And so now it's, okay, what are the new projects? And so, as far as that, something that popped in my mind that, you know, was an idea before, I just haven't gotten around to it, is doing an audiobook for my first novel, which would be fun, right? And I was thinking about, part of me wants to get somebody with an amazing voice to read it rather than just me. So I'm going to talk to some people, or maybe I just might do it myself. I don't know. We'll see. Obviously, you know, doing it myself would be fun, and to re-experience the novel by reading it out loud. But at the same time, it could be just be fun hearing somebody else do it, right? So we'll see. The other thing, you know, one of our friends is a comedy writer, and he wants to start doing a couple sketches, and so I'm like, yeah, for any time I'm available, I'm down to, let's do it, you know, and kind of go from there. So we're going to film some stuff this week, you know, and it's pretty simple stuff. So yeah, I'm looking forward to just having fun with a, you know, funny group of people, essentially. And the biggest sort of thing that I've been putting off for a while is writing my second novel. And though I've had like a start-stop, you know, it's outline, I've got a couple of you know, chapters written and so forth. It's now it's time to like really buckle down because I can and really get to it. And so starting today, I've essentially like, now this is it, you know, this is the next project that I'm dedicating to, you know, effort into. And this is the top priority, right? So in that sense, I'm looking forward to that and being able to share that experience, you know? And the film will be sort of secondary because my involvement isn't as great, you know? Not meaning like, you know, the amount of time, right? Anyway, yeah, that's the long and short of it. As always, feel free to ask questions down in the comment box or hit me up on social media at Phil Svitek. It can be about anything that I've talked about or anything you would like me to talk about. Would love to share and discuss. Thank you so much for watching. As always, if you appreciate what I do and think you would benefit from more direct interaction, well, that's what my Patreon page is for, patreon.com/PhilSvitek. Likewise, I've talked about the various projects that I have, and those are all available to you. They're linked to down below. Supporting that stuff helps support this because it's symbiotic, right? By doing that stuff, I can talk about it here and share the lessons and insights learned along the way. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. I hope to see you next time.